My name is Robbie Harmsworth and I'm a Melbourne-based artist working out of a studio in North Melbourne. This current body of work is about Inanna, a Sumerian goddess, the story of which was discovered on clay tablets around about the 1700s. The myth is about Inanna's descent, and she goes to visit her sister in the underworld. And to do this, she has to pass through seven gates. At each gate, she has to divest herself of a garment until she arrives naked at the entrance to the underworld. When she arrives at the underworld, her sister, Ereshkigal, hangs her from a hook. She hangs there for 3 days and three nights, and finally her father, God Enki, god of water, sends two emissaries down to save Inanna by feeding her the water and food of life. The seven gates have been put onto Japanese paper that I've treated with on caustic. Firstly, I've had them screen printed with an image, a repeated image of very beautiful French gates that hold great personal relevance to me. They hang in the gallery space, and as you walk past them, they emit a smell of beeswax, which I find very evocative. As Inanna passes through each gate, she has to divest herself of a garment, and these garments represent the trappings of the worldly state. And I've made the royal robes out of tarlatan, and I've made the crown from the dodder laurel leaves that I've woven and then placed dried roses in the crown. The lapis lazuli beads are made from clay that then I've treated with indigo paint. And her breastplate is moulded from encaustic and tarlatan as well. She's hanging over a rock, and on that rock I've beaten some lead into the form of a cross and placed a vessel filled with gold leaf, and that's symbolic of the alchemical process of turning lead base metal into something precious, which is gold. I really enjoyed making the two-dimensional works. It was almost a meditative process of collaging symbols, both drawing and etching, onto the beautiful Kozo paper using the encaustic medium. And they were framed in such a way that the luminosity of the encaustic treated images is maintained. By elevating the work on acrylic lugs off the base of the frame, the light is allowed to pass through the piece and thus gives a beautiful otherworldliness to the encaustic process. Descent myths have had a strong influence on my work in the past, and I'm sure that the central motifs of journeying through darkness to a resurrected and altered state will continue.